Welcome back to Tech Yes City, and I've got a Ford Focus packed full of PC parts right here. And surprisingly, this Ford Focus, I'm kidding you not, this thing can fit more parts in it than the Stinger could, so I'm really impressed. We got over 10 cases in this car, in the boxes, and I also got 10 power supplies, as well as a water cooler for my main rig, which my main rig, I brought this mini ITX PC back to Australia, and the problem is it was fine in Japan, but now with it literally being like 20 degrees hotter here, I'm having problems keeping the 13900K under control. So I got a water cooler for that, but we'll talk about water coolers later, where it's very important to get the right water cooler. Even within these parts that I bought here, I bought some Cougar parts. They were really cheap in terms of value for money, but when it came to the water cooler, I had to spend a bit extra, and that was because there's a lot of different models out there that have high failure rates. So we'll talk about that later, but what we got right here is the Archon V2. It's got three RGB fans, it's got a clear side panel mesh front, and this is getting, I was getting these for about $75 now a pop, and that's pretty good value, but it is a step up from what I was previously getting as my main runabout case. And that was from actually a friend. He ordered a custom container full of these cases with four ARGB fans and tempered glass and had an LED strip down the side. And I was getting them from anywhere from 50 to 60 Aussie, depending on how many I bought off my friend. And the problem is there, he's sold out of them all though, since I've been gone in Japan and I've come back. But I did have a stash of a few of them that I had lying around. I've actually gone through all of them, so I've got none of those cases left. But the Cougar parts are going to have to do the job. So unfortunately, those cases and those prices are out of the picture. So we're left with the Cougar now, which hopefully is not going to sap the youth out of me or anyone else in Australia. I mean, it's the materialistic kind. It is not the Cougar that when you go out on the town, you have to be aware of. So I'm hoping these are the good Cougars, but we'll only find out after we do a bit of testing on them, where we also got the 500 watt power supplies for $48 a piece. And that's coming in a little bit lower than all the other people I can find selling power supplies. Anyway though, we're at U-Mart right now, and I've got to pick up some DDR4 memory, which is going cheap. And I'll also put up the USD pricing on the screen for you guys, where this is for a 16 gigabyte kit, RGB 2x8 sticks, and we've got 3200 megahertz on that too. So that actually DDR4 memory right now is really cheap. So let's go get that, then we'll get back to the Tech Yes studio. And we've also got two other deals later on today to pick up, as well as lining up two flips.
If you want to get yourself a cheap, legit Windows 10 Pro Key license, then today's video sponsor SCD Keys has you covered. For as little as $14, when you use that coupon code BFTYC, you can get Windows activated right now. Links in the description below.
And we're now back at the Tech Yes studio with our second PC to build up. We've just built up one and flipped it just before. That was in a hurry. And that was an i7-4790, 16 gigabytes of RAM, Lenovo motherboard adapter, and then we had 75 on the case, 50 on the SSD, 50 on the power supply, 100 on the 1650 Super. So all up, I'd say that build cost me around 400-ish. And so we are making a good 250 profit on that, which is, again, it's decent. It's really solid given the market right now. And now we're gonna build up the second one, which is gonna be another 650 flip. And I got to drop this one off, but good thing is it's close to the Ryzen 5 1600 pickup, so that makes it all worth the while. And this one here, I don't know how much this is going to owe me, because I literally picked that X79 up out of the dumpster, same with a 3930K. So we're just adding in 16 gigabytes of RAM. So I was figuring I was going to chuck in a 1650 Super with it and just make the buyer pretty happy, because originally my listing was like a GTX 1070. And so what I do is, like, when I run out of those parts, I essentially just tell the person, look, I don't have anything left unless you're keen on this, and I'll list the specs, and they're like, yep, I'll take that. So that's what we're going to do right now.
Keep
we just now finished up with a 2-in-1 combo. We got the Ryzen 5 1600 CPU, and we also dropped off that PC. I actually ended up swapping the i7 3930K and the X79 for a 4790 and B85. And it was the same price because they wanted that over the 3930K. And I mean, me personally, I would prefer the X79 3930K, but I guess you just gotta give people what they want. But that being said, it's 8 p.m. at night and I gotta get home and make some dinner. And I gotta say, I love this late night hustle. It's awesome. It's good being back in Australia, and you just can't do this in Japan. There's no really door-to-door deliveries, no pickups. It's a different culture. Honestly, taking the risks, taking the gambles, working for that flip, getting it all to work in the end is what it's all about at Tech Yes City. But also later tonight, since I've run out of PCs on my current ads, I've got to refresh two PCs and get out ads. But also, if you guys are selling on Facebook Marketplace, for me, I've found I only have max 3 listings on PCs because the other listings will just get buried. So max 3 listings, and so you want to have those 3 listings up and take advantage of that. And we are now back with the Ryzen 5 1600 and the cooler for it, the big chunky first gen Ryzen cooler, but we have a B550 here. And the biggest problem with that is I'm pretty sure Ryzen first and even second gen doesn't work B550. So we'll come back to that in the morning because I'll probably have to get a Ryzen 5 3600 or something for this motherboard and then try and find something. I should have something else. I think I might have like a B350 lying around that I can pair with this anyhow. And in the meantime, we still got that. So that's, I guess, one PC we can quickly put together and list tonight, so it's ready for some of those early morning PC gaming PC hunters. It is now early in the morning and I've completed 2 PC builds. One with a RTX 3080 and a Ryzen 7. Actually, we used that Ryzen 7 3700X kit that we got from the used parts hunt with an RTX 3080 that we got in Japan. So that one should actually create a lot of value. And we also had one of those old school cases actually in my storage. And so I was able to utilize that. But there's also the white Archon V2. We use the white case on this build that we set up with 32 gigabytes of RAM, i7-3930K, and a 6700 XT. So hopefully that build does pretty well. And I mean, I'm just really utilizing all the parts that I've got left behind here, but I'm also looking to pick up some more parts today. And I found a 3600X for 160 Aussie, but I put in an offer of 110. So hopefully they accept that because that'll go with that B550 motherboard absolutely fine. And then after that, I've actually got, I think, a friend with a B350 motherboard. They're a miner that packed up shop. So we should be able to pick up some of those components, maybe something like a power supply and a B350 motherboard, and use that with the Ryzen 5 1600. So what we're doing here is just really creating value out of any step that we can, as well as looking constantly on the market to sort of, if there's deals that haven't sold for a few weeks and people are willing to accept lower offers, or if there's new things coming up as well. And so I found a 3060, an RTX 3060, they're asking 370 Aussie, and I just said, what's the lowest you'll take? And they're looking for around 350 for it. And then there's a 3060 Ti that I can get for 400 Aussie. So they seem okay, but at the moment, I just don't have the motherboards and CPUs, and I'm not really finding much there in terms of matching those GPUs for good value. So what I'm gonna do in the meantime is I'm gonna install this water cooler on my mini ITX rig and also talk to you guys about some other things in the market right now, as well as I think it's like, it's past NDA date as well. And I think the 7900 XT is coming in the mail today. So I don't know what happened there. Like I called AMD as soon as I got back to Australia. I was like, I was really keen to check out 7900 XTX. And they said, oh, well, they've all gone out to other reviewers. But we have a 7900 XT. I'm like, okay, cool. That'd be good because maybe that's a model that might be more in stock than the 7900 XTX. I don't know. Love to check it out. And they're like, yeah, we'll get it to you. And then nothing happened. And yesterday I called them and then suddenly there's like an email. It's on its way. It's coming to you overnight shipping. So maybe, I don't know. When you're in this game long enough, just some crazy stuff can happen. But let's update this mini ITX rig and see how good it turns out. And now I just got back and completed this final little rig here. This is just going to be the budget banger that we did with the $100 gaming PC. And we're just adding in a monitor, keyboard, and mouse. Now, these keyboards and mice, I was blown away by the value that they're offering. They were down at a local office work store for around 15 Aussie dollars for the keyboard and the mouse. And that'd be around $10 US for you guys in the States. And I've never seen a keyboard and mouse this cheap that actually looks this good. And surprisingly, I mean, first impressions are that it's actually a really good implementation of a membrane keyboard. Nothing feels cheap at all. And the mouse actually is a decent shape and the clicks are quite solid. So I bought six of them. I bought all the ones down at the local one to me, but there was actually a viewer who watches the channel down at the Office Works, and he checked the stock levels, and there's a heap of these at other stores on the Gold Coast here. So I might go do a raid on these keyboard and mice combos just because I've never seen them this cheap before for something of this quality. So really drop that one there, but I guess that's a stress test for it. So really good quality from this surprising little pickup here. And when you do that RGB, it just adds to a build, especially if you've got a really basic looking case and a basic monitor. It kind of gives it a little bit of bling. Anyhow guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video, behind the scenes look at Tech Yes City and how the hustle unfolds. And it just sort of ends up working really smoothly in the end. It's a really big bunch of chaos that comes together. And for me, the end is all that matters, the result. And that's what I always focus on, getting the final product. And of course, how we get there by any means possible. And I guess that's the journey here at Tech Yes City. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this one. And I get asked a lot in the comments about what goes on behind the scenes, how do I price builds up? And we're gonna quickly stop at that question, how do I price things up? It's all just the head, the calculator in the head. I just sort of always know what I'm paying for particular parts and I try to move them fast. And so that way I'm always not going to risk getting caught out, as I know actually quite a few sellers did get caught out by buying up a lot of stock earlier this year at higher prices, and now prices have come down a lot. And maybe some of them might be nervous right now, but again, that is one of those things where you can go with slow turnover, but you do risk sitting on potential losses as opposed to high turnover. You're just working fast and you're getting out the value. And I think that's what the market prefers. I prefer that. I mean, stay active. Also, one more bonus thing for you guys that have stayed this far as well is water coolers. There's a reason I bought that Cougar water cooler, the more expensive one over the cheaper ones. And that's because I got some friends in retail. They tell me things that go on with these particular models of coolers from brands. And I know right now with Cougar and MSI, pretty much all MSI water coolers, I would avoid them as they do get random returns here and there. And then the Cougar models, the cheaper ones, I would avoid them as they are prone to becoming faulty as well. Or at least not, I'm not talking about massive faults in terms of every cooler is going to fail, but the person I spoke to said they've never had a Cougar Valor, I think it was, or Hiller. I just forgot the model name. I booked it up. I'll put the model name up on the screen for you guys, but they've never had that particular model come back
to them, and they've actually gone through quite a few of them for client builds. So that's always good news to hear. And as well as the XTC power supplies, they're really good as well. They've never seen one of those come back, which is surprising considering they're a pretty cheap price for what they are, at least in Australia. Anyway, we got the question of the day here, which comes from Bishop Shepherd 1205, and they ask, is an 8-pin that is 6+2 considered pigtailed? Well, I think with the 6-pin and the 8-pin, there was different power ratings for just a 6-pin versus an 8-pin, but technically they got the same positive voltage wires on them, so I would say no, it's not a pigtailed cable. Pigtail generally refers to, with PCIe cables, the 8 piggybacking off the back of another 8-pin, so just off one cable going to the power supply. So in other words, there's 2 8-pins off of one cable. That's what is generally considered pigtail. Though in terms of a 6-pin, you can get power supplies with really thick positive gauge that may even do more power through a 6-pin than a power supply with an 8-pin. So the 8-pin was generally made though just as a standard for higher power, even though those extra 2 wires don't carry positive 12 volt wire through them. Anyhow, hope that answers that question. And if you stayed this far, then you know what to do. Hit that like button and also smash that sub button if you haven't already. Ring the bell to get the content as soon as it drops. And I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.